Just came back from visiting NIE malls earlier. Of course, we didn't enter the malls premises. I went out to greet Malay residents. NIE malls is not exactly within the Hougang SMC, but I thought it was important for me to go out and meet a lot of the residents who I've touched base with over the last 1 year. I want to let them know that they're important to me. We do not have a lot of Malay residents in Hougang area. From about 7%. I want to let them know that they're not forgotten during this period of time. They hold an important place in our policies and the way we want to reach out to the community. We see very warm response this time round. They came out and said that, you know, thank you so much for a couple of the assistance cases we have out. And they say they're going to ask more people whom they know who are in financial need to come to us. So we're going to be following up with those issues. And this is a lot of it, it's about my vision of what a vibrant and multicultural Hougang is going to be like. We need to be cohesive. We need to be able to bring together residents of different races, different religions together. So you'll find us, even our programs to date, as very multicultural. All residents of all ages and races are involved. So you'll see us going to do more of that, making sure that we see ourselves as multicultural Hougang. It's not going to be just a Chinese place, a Teochew place, but it's a place for everyone. And the Malay residents were very encouraged by that. They said that, you know, we really want to see, we really have events going on, programs. But yes, I think definitely more can be done. And they hope that I can deliver it to them. So I'm very touched by that. Over the course of the last 3 days, or 2.5, you know, this day is not exactly over yet. Visited quite a few blocks. Of course, I had a chance to speak to a few youths. Interestingly, they told us that, you know, there's a connection there. We already started talking about some sports programs and stuff. They wanted to have a say in how Hougang will be like in the next 20 years. I think that it's important for youth to be involved. You'll find me as a younger person wanting to champion that, to make sure that our youth play an active role in shaping what the community is like. I'm going to be able to want to push forward a forum, a youth policy forum for youth in Hougang, so that they can have their say. A unique say from Hougang residents' perspectives of what national policy should be like. And this can then be shared with the larger public thereafter. But also look forward to having more youth volunteers to come and join by community, for community concept. We already have been getting a lot of young residents who come on board, but I think more can be. A few of them have said that, you know, please sign up, please come on board, let us know when we come in and help. The youngest that I've gotten was a P6 kid, you know, said that I want to find out what, how do you go about assisting people. So I'm very encouraged by that. I think that's one direction that we can go towards. Besides the forum, besides getting more to come as volunteers or social assistants, we also want them to have regular workshops. So for career guiding, career counselling, industry sharing. These are some of the things that we can bring forward. Because of my position as NTUC, as a unionist, because we know different companies, know different industries, and we can involve youth in that to let them know what are the different career options, to know what are the exciting challenges that they face. But importantly, to also let them know what are the challenges that this nation face and what will take for us to take Singapore forward.
Actually, this is from a few older people who said, Hougang, the future. 在于我们后港的年轻人，他们已经辛苦了，这样多年，辛辛的工作，他们已经把他们的家庭给顾了，家庭孩子也大，可是后港的未来还是必须交给年轻一代。他们说，你比较年轻，可以比较容易跟我们年轻一代沟通，比较容易了解他们的心声，可能你可以代表他们，打造后港20年的未来。所以对我来说。
身为一个比较年轻，就现在30岁还不算老了，蛮年轻的，比较容易跟年轻人沟通。譬如说，我们有时在球场，他们就谈说，哎，你知道我们保利的那个车子方面有没有concession，这样可以帮你。所以我们在不同，我可以在不同的场合接触这些问题，反映他们的心声。所以我觉得这是我可以扮演的角色。
你觉得网络的利用网络重要吗？
当然，会有一定的，因为有很多的居民
是蛮年轻的，其实也对蛮多年长者也是开始用 Facebook 的，他们也是有跟我说，我看见你的照片了，啊，虽然他们那个英文字会看很多，说我看到了，啊，所以啊，我们会在不同的管道，啊，来跟我们的居民畅谈。
The rally dates will be announced in due course. We'll make sure that all of you will know, because we also want our supporters to come and attend. So they will not be until today.
Would it be tomorrow?
Oh, I'm not sure. Due course.
Do you intend to have more than once?
I think we have as many as needed. We find that the plan here has always been to reach out to residents as best as we can, and as intimate and as personal as possible could. So, but also some residents told us that, we also like to see you during a rally. They said, we seen you last year, we'd like to see you again. So I hope also not to disappoint them. Not too sure whether one is enough or two is enough, but in due course, we'll let you know, and as many as needed.
What about any daytime rally or indoor daily rally?
I think whatever that is the most effective to reach out to them. We have our plans, and we'll make sure that we keep you in the loop.
I've been working on low workers issues for quite some time. I'm an NTUC unionist, helping out my low-income workers in the security industry, especially. It's been central to me. I was with the food train sector. I know that in the service industry, the port workers, tough, very blue-collar work, hard to control. Security employees, of course, is very tough, long hours. So we know how to work on. And I'm going to work on them in a very tangible way. Say, for example, it's very hard to address a low-wage worker issue in a broad stroke. Broad stroke thing like National Wages Council, we can do that. But we also need individual industry specific plans. Say for example, plans for the security industry. Right now we're doing a national survey on the HR practices in the security industry, making sure that we know and benchmark ourselves on progress. Find out for ourselves why people stay in the industry, why they leave, what is needed from the employer's perspective on how to increase wages. The best of initiatives. So very tangible steps to make those changes. And those are important. We can always highlight low wages issues, but we must be also able to articulate what are the real concrete steps to do so. And we have our plans already there. I think a lot of people have covered the labor beat. We know that we have been working on this concrete stuff.
Two questions. Is there one issue that you find that you have to address immediately in outcome? And the second one is, how do you find yourself connecting with
users? I think for the first issue, the first big thing that we need to tackle, of course, we need to make sure that the daily and local amenities are taken care of. Today, over the past 2.5 days, in fact, over the last months, residents have been saying that when will the day happen whereby I don't get caught in the rain when I go to the bus stop for the blocks? So I want to make sure those are the most basic things we take care of first. Because my work for the low-income workers are all ongoing at the same time. But really tangible things are delivered to them, that's that. I know the MND still owes me a response for the market issue. So I'm waiting to hear from that. If they don't give us a response, we're going to push it again. Use promotion, I think. I want to be able to reach out to them from the perspective that I'm not far from you, from an issue. I've gone through tough times, and the times are also equally challenging. I just got married, some of the tough things about housing, some of the hard stuff about how do you balance work life. Even the youth, when I get onto the court, what kind of issues they face? Some like, what kind of industry should I get into after I graduate? You see them asking for that kind of inputs. Even on the sidelines during halftime, they'll say that, ask them, what are your plans after college? They say that, should I go do this and that? I can play that role. And if they have things they don't want to voice out, they say that, I want to have a say on why are we not getting transport concession for poly students. And I say that, come to my round table, come to my youth policy forum, and let's talk through that. Let's make sure that we give a concrete shape and structure to our voice as youths of Hougang. I think that's something that we can push through quite effectively. And being a youth myself, I think I can take on that.
当然，对很多这个年轻人来说，他们说，我们毕竟在这边成长，说20多年、30年，他们说，其实这很多年来，其实改变的不多，
他们说，欸，如果你真的要改变后港的话，你怎样注射新的生命力？所以我就跟他们讲，欸，我的计划是怎么样，怎样跟多跟年轻人沟通，多给他们一个平台，能影响这个国家的政策，就会从我的角度来讲。Well, of course, as a young Vietnamese, who have also worked in police, doing very proud issues, I think I bring a different perspective. I've seen things from different sides. People will fell down and out, what actually crimes. I've seen how youth that are not taken care of, probably their families, get repeatedly involved in problems, ground level, they get a proper job. I also have seen how yellow ribbon people finally have to integrate in society. And I also seen how that they're trapped in certain type of jobs as a unionist. So I bring together a very different background, a very different perspective. And I think that you can never have too many youths in parliament. Because the future of Singapore depends on us. If people from my generation and younger do not step up, then I'll be very worried about how Singapore is going to be. Yes, it is aging. We have a lot of older people, but never forget the Chinese saying that it's always incumbent upon the young to take care of old. So it's time for the young people in Hougang to step up and say that, hey, you know, we want to change, and that we want to make sure that we are in the role to define how our elderly are taken care of.
Well, to me, the Yang Shin Long episode has always been a close chapter, mentioned at the press conference, and it continues to be the case. This is the by-election between two candidates, and that is Pengang Huat and myself. The residents will have to choose between the two of us. I think they will want somebody who has always been there for them and will continue to be there for them. They will also want to know who has been working hard for them and serving them, making the difference in their lives. I think that's how they will approach this by-election. And this is how I'm going to continue my campaign. To be to reach out to every one of them, touch one heart at a time, and make sure that we serve them, even as we go along this campaign trail.
Lastly, encourage them to vote for parliamentary democracy by supporting
the candidates. I can't really comment on that because it's really up to the residents to decide. I think residents want to look at it from the perspective of who has been there for them, who will be for them, who will be there for them. Be there for them. That's always been on top of a lot of the minds of the residents whom I spoke to today. They said that, no, you want continuity. I want to make sure that the service to us is there and that we can do more together. They've given me their confidence, and I think that a lot of them will be approaching this by-election from this perspective.
Mm.
其实对我来说，这个姚兴隆事件也到了一个段落。我在那个先在那个记者招待会的时候说过，现在也要重申说，这真的是告了一个段落。非常欣慰的知道，兴隆呢，他决定在外国再从头再开始，也跟他的家庭们一起在这个外国发展，非常开心，我会祝福他。对我们来说呢，我还是会走自己的路，因为很多居民跟我说，也反映说，他们需要一个始终如一，不会始乱终弃的议员，所以我会从这个角度来面对这个事件，而对很多居民来说，这个补选呢，真的就是从两者来选，就是方文发还有朱贝欣，而不是姚兴隆。方荣发和朱碧清，所以我觉得他们从这角度来看，谢谢。